Coming up next, Tuesday night NBA hoops with a Midwest flavor as the Spurs take on the Jazz. Utah's in the thick of the race for the best record in the West. John Stockton once again setting the table. And Karl Malone is dishing out about 26 points and 11 boards a night for the Midwest leaders. The Jazz home against the Spurs next on TNT.
For most people in the world, the intense power of the F-16 is thousands of feet above. For you, it's a phone call away. The Air Force Reserve, a great way to serve.
Life is empty, torturous.
I yearn wanting more.
Wanting more.
There's a burning from within.
Here's a tip. Eat something.
I recommend the new Extreme Carvers from Boston Market, like the chicken cheese stick. Juicy, slow-roasted chicken, peppers, and onions smothered in four ooey-gooey cheeses. Now get a free side and a free drink when you buy an Extreme Chicken Cheese Stick. Only at Boston Market.
Well, that burning from within, it's called hunger.
People call you guys bunny spotters, is that right?
Bunny spotters. I think that it trivializes what we do. It's much larger than that.
I mean, once you've seen it, you can never go back. There's no other pink like that. Who's been through here?
Bum, bum.
You see anything yet?
Bum, bum. Bum,
bum. I've seen it 16 times. To watch somebody find it, see it for the first time.
I feel very fortunate to be here because, you know, when we're all gone, I'm still going to be out there.
Vin Baker to NBA Chess Pass Drill Level B.
Vin, thanks for coming. I'd like to show you something.
Jersey test, positive.
Commence starter stock performance analysis.
Did these with the others.
Today we're simulating a home game to test thermal protection.
Yeah! You're the man!
You ever been to Milwaukee?
Temperature reduction in progress.
The following is an exclusive presentation of Turner Sports.
It seems only fitting that the first player to lead the New Orleans Jazz onto the NBA stage carried a Western moniker. And while Pete Maravich's scintillating style was music to most, New Orleans was not listening. In 79, a franchise seeking new life found a home in the serene landscape that surrounds the Great Salt Lake. Against the backdrop of the snow-capped Wasatch Range, the Jazz settled in Utah, their new home, and discovered a talented tandem who quickly rose to the peak of their profession. In 84, the Jazz found John Stockton, a true steal from tiny Gonzaga, who in no time was pointing the team toward the playoffs. The next year brought the powerful Malone, a dominant force, and the perfect partner for Stockton. Together, they have become legends in this valley and the basketball world beyond. Stockton and Malone, the soul of the Jazz. It has been a spectacular midwinter day here in the Great Salt Lake. And now as the sun sets over the crossroads of the West, more than 19,000 make their way inside the Delta Center for an early starting encounter, the second meeting this season between these two division rivals, the San Antonio Spurs and the Utah Jazz. And what a chase it's going to be from now till the end of the regular season for the top seed in the West. Were the playoffs to begin tonight, the Lakers would be on top, followed by Utah, Seattle, and Houston. But it's anybody's guess how that's going to wind up. Good evening, everybody. I'm Vern Lundquist. Welcome to Salt Lake. In his 9 years as head coach of the Jazz, one thing has marked Jerry Sloan's team. They have been consistent winners. Three times in the last 5 years in the Western Conference Finals, and they've yet, however, to make it to the NBA Finals. I'm joined by Doc Rivers again. And, Doc, how would you assess their chances again this year?
I love their chances. No one picks this team, and you look at this team,
team. They have the second best record in the West. They're 6-2 against the elite teams in the West. They're virtually unbeatable at home. You have John Stockton, Karl Malone, two dream teamers, and for the Watts, they have a great bench. And that bench is Shedden Anderson. He's a rookie, and he's playing great for this team. And due to his play, his defensive presence at the big guard, I think they have the best chance they've ever had to make it to the finals.
Well, they take on a San Antonio team that is going through misery right now. A year ago, when you were a part of the team, they were 36-13. Now decimated by injury, they've won only 12. And I know you're really sympathetic to what they're going through.
Yeah, you feel sorry for the team. You feel sorry for guys like Vinny Del Negro and Avery Johnson, who are used to winning. Avery Johnson is the spiritual leader of this team, and he knows that they're not 12-37 because they lack talent. They're 12-37 because they lack talent that is healthy. But Avery still has to come out every night, be the leader, and be positive. And if he's not positive and doesn't lead, they have no chance of winning.
Well, tonight the schedule says they have a formidable task as they take on Utah. There has been more than just a little bit going on in the league. I don't think it's escaped your attention. When we come back, Reggie Miller joins his sister and Ernie Johnson in Atlanta.
The NBA on TNT is brought to you by Brewery Fresh Budweiser, who reminds you fresh beer tastes better. By Chrysler and the Cab Forward Sedans of Chrysler. What's new in your world? By Domino's Pizza. For Haunted Wow, call Domino's now. By Imodium AD, one-dose relief you can count on. And by AT&T.
Oh, no.
Everything at Chrysler is new. New cars, new ways to save. Right now, you can get $1,000 cash back on Chrysler Cirrus. Or lease Chrysler LHS for just $359 a month. Or get $1,500 cash back on the Chrysler Concord LXI. Everything at Chrysler is new. New cars, new ways to save. For a limited time only at your Chrysler dealer. What's new in your world?
How about something hot? Just look for the dot. Choose from three delicious crusts. There's classic hand-tossed, crunchy thin crust, thick ultimate deep dish.
Wow.
Whatever you wish. So tell us how and pick one now. Call now and you can enjoy a delicious Domino's pizza during the game. And why not add on some of Domino's spicy buffalo wings or steaming hot breadsticks?
Nothing takes you out of the action faster than a diarrhea medicine that can let you down. But you can count on Imodium AD to stop diarrhea often in one dose. You could end up taking dose after dose after dose of the pink stuff to stop diarrhea as effectively as Imodium AD. Don't take chances when you have diarrhea. Take Imodium AD, one dose relief you can count on.
We're all about family values here. Ernie Johnson in Atlanta, joined by a brother and sister tag team tonight. Cheryl Miller's a regular. Reggie's in town for a game with the Hawks tomorrow night. You will hear from those two in just a second. In three full seasons as the Magic head coach, Brian Hill averaged nearly 56 wins a year. Took Orlando to the playoffs each time and to the finals once. This year, with Shaq gone and Penny Hardaway missing nearly half Orlando's games and the Magic a game under 500, Hill was fired. GM John Gabriel said the decision came after hearing from the players.
As far as, you know, players pushing a coach out, I do not see it that way. You know, players, these players were unified in their thoughts. Naturally, some of them different thoughts and different perspectives on the situation, but felt collectively, in order to move forward, this would be their recommendation.
Let me throw something out here, gang. I think John Gabriel's on dangerous ground here if he gives the players too much leeway, too much say in how an organization is run, and I think it really undercuts the authority of a head coach. Reg?
Well, sometimes you know you don't want the inmates running the jailhouse, and I think I know it's kind of looked like that a little bit, but I think as a whole, when the Magic got together as a team on a silent meeting and they voted 12-0, that they wanted a new coach. I think something had to be done.
Well, you know, guys, what I find odd is I just 9 days ago read an article in a newspaper in Orlando, and John Gabriel was sitting up there spouting the greatness of Brian Hill and how he thought he was one of the best young coaches of the future of the NBA. And now 9 days later, now granted they lost five in a row, but 9 days later that he isn't getting the job done, something simply doesn't add up here.
And he said he hoped the stragglers out there who didn't believe that Brian Hill could get the job done would finally join the ranks here. And now Brian Hill is gone. Richie Adubato, by the way, has the reins, at least for the time being. The three of us are going to be back at halftime. More on the Orlando story, last night's nine-player swap, and highlights. But coming right up, we're going to take you back to the Delta Center, the Spurs and the Jazz. Enjoy it.
You know, I've been telling you about the AT&T One Rate plan.
One rate anytime.
Well, now there's the AT&T One Rate International plan.
International?
Yeah, each country has its own low rate on calls from home anytime.
What country?
Almost any country you can think of.
Each with its own low rate.
Exactly.
One rate to Sweden anytime.
Yeah.
I can call Chile.
Yeah, Chile would love to hear from you.
What do you know in Chile?
Like you're so busy calling Sweden.
I can call Sweden.
All right, what happened there?
One low rate per country anytime. The AT&T One Rate International plan.
Baby Ruth presents Moments with Great American Heroes.
Sure. I'll level with you. I've lost a step.
I can't even make it around the world in 2 seconds anymore.
I'm not going to kid you. I need a boost. The chewy nougat caramel and tons of roasted peanuts and a Baby Ruth is what I need to get me to hyperspeed.
Without that extra energy, I barely cracked the sound barrier.
Excuse me.
I had to stop a volcano from destroying Hawaii.
Any calls while I was gone?
Baby Ruth from Nestle. This baby gets you going.
The Star Wars trilogy is back on the big screen, and each planet is celebrating in a different way. On Earth, people are playing Feel the Force at Taco Bell. Press the game piece to magically reveal if you've instantly won cash, one of millions of prizes, or a special edition Hummer. See the trilogy, Feel the Force. Play the game at Taco Bell.
Are you sure this is the right theater?
I'm not even sure it's the right planet.
Delta Center, the site of this second game in 1997 between the San Antonio Spurs and the Utah Jazz. Starting lineup tonight for the Spurs, Avery Johnson, Vernon Maxwell in the backcourt, Carl Herrera, Cadillac Anderson, and Dominique Cook up front. And for the Utah Jazz, John Stockton, Jeff Hornacek at the guards, Brian Russell, Greg Ostertag, and Carl Malone up front. Well, it has been indeed a very busy 24 hours in the National Basketball Association. And for more on what's going on, let's check in with Dick Versace.
Well, Vern, wow, that was some trade last night. I wish I had some more trade information for you, but I don't. But I did run into Dominique Wilkins in an elevator today, and you know, you can learn a lot in an elevator. He said, I think I'm going to be traded before the deadline, Dick, and I think I may be going to the L.A. Lakers. I also have heard that it's possible that Dominique Wilkins could end up in a purple uniform right here with the Utah Jazz.
That is interesting.
That is interesting. I think Dominique Wilkins would be a great addition to the Utah Jazz for lots of reasons. But first of all, because of Jerry Sloan. Jerry Sloan's a tough guy, and Dominique would fit into that mode, and he would force him into that mode if he didn't want to be in it. And I think it'd be a good fit for Dominique.
Utah at 36-14. They lead in the division over Houston by three. Hugh Evans, Nolan Fine, Leroy Richardson are the officials for tonight. John Stockton has it in his hands, picked up by Avery Johnson. Now Hornacek and Carl Malone, who will take the first shot of the ball game.
Well, talking to Greg Popovich before the game, that's what he said he was going to give is the outside jumper. He wants to try to keep the Jazz out of the paint, make them beat them from outside. He thinks that gives them the best chance of winning tonight.
Here's Carl Herrera, guarded by Malone, and there's a reach in by John Stockton, knocks it out of bounds. Carl Herrera one of the masked marvels playing for the Spurs.
Yeah, it's not the most charming looking thing I've seen in my lifetime, but it's effective.
Yeah, it's better looking than when Will Perdue comes in, though.
Yes, it is.
Carl Herrera rode in unobtrusively. Here's Malone again, picked up by Herrera. Nice pass underneath. Brian Russell gets it quickly.
The one thing you'll see all night, this team runs their offense better than any team in the NBA, and that's why you have to give them a chance of going all the way, at least going to the finals, because of their offensive efficiency.
Maxwell, before the shot is fouled, Jeff Hornacek picks it up. Take a look at that Malone pass.
They cut, they know where each other is at, and you'll see backdoor cuts, movement cuts, and passes all night long. This team runs their offense.
Avery Johnson guarded by John Stockton. There's the pick and roll. Herrera gets the return pass, up and under. Ostertag is there. Now it's knocked loose again. That's the second time they've reached in and gotten the ball. Malone all the way.
Second reaching tonight. This is one of the few teams also defensively that teaches reaching. You know, in high school, in grade school, the coach says, no reach, no reach. Well, Jerry Sloan believes that the reach is an important part to their defense.
Take a look at this reach now. Look at Malone and Stockton.
What they teach here is you can't get to the ball, reach down and try to get it before they get it up. Right there, the backboard did a lot of the shot blocking. That'll help you also.
And 7'2" Greg Ostertag with the block. Now Jerry Sloan, 9 years here. You grew up watching him play for the Bulls.
Yeah, him and Norm Van Leer. I don't know if there's two guards who are similar in the NBA like those two guys. Those are the two toughest guards to ever play the game of basketball.
Dominic Wilkins will inbound, gets it in the hands of Herrera.
And good early timeout by the coach. He wants to try to keep this game as close as possible. And that's a nice timeout. Gather the troops. Guys, we're down 6-0. Let's not let these guys get too far ahead.
Greg Popovich, who succeeded Bob Hill after the Spurs got off to a horrible start. Without it, must be said, the big guy, David Robinson. Here's the jumper from Dominic Wilkins.
David Robinson obviously missed. I think one of the key guys on the team who no one talks about who is missing is Chuck Person. He gives them threes, he gives them toughness, gives them a lot of the intangibles that they don't have without him.
Avery Johnson hurries it down, finds Maxwell in the corner. Ostertag with the rebound. Now Utah will run. Right side to Brian Russell. Travel.
Now that's one of those carrying calls that you don't see a lot in the NBA, and he did it. Boy, did he do it.
Cadillac Anderson starting in place of Will Perdue. Perdue is back tonight. Perdue missed 5 games with an eye socket fracture and then a couple more with a bum ankle. The woes keep going. Oh, what a pass.
Great pass by Dominique. Something he's not known for, but that was a great find and getting a great cut by Vernon. San Antonio needs points, and those are the type of baskets that will help them along. They need a bunch of easy baskets. You look at their team without David Robinson and Sean Elliott, and their two offensive guys, they have to manufacture points somehow.
Hornacek, no. Cadillac Anderson with a rebound. And Avery Johnson hurries it up. Sean Elliott, by the way, did undergo successful surgery today on his knee, out 6 to 8 weeks. Watching the game tonight from the hospital, Russell from Hornacek. Two more.
Oh, great, great, great release. You don't see that very often, and that is something you love seeing, is just throwing the ball ahead, beating the team back. Transition defense is a concern for Greg Popovich.
This Utah team averages 26 assists per game. That's tops in the league. Already 4 baskets. And they got a pretty good guy knocking balls backward in there, Greg Ostertag.
Yeah, Greg Ostertag's playing a great role for this team. He knows that's why Utah is so good. They play off of Stockton and Malone, and all the other guys know their roles. Ostertag's role is to be the garbage man on defense, get some block shots and some rebounds, and he's doing a great job of that for this team.
Maxwell, they need his shot tonight. Didn't get that one. Loose ball, out of bounds. Transition defense, a concern of Greg Popovich tonight.
Yeah, it is. Here you'll see the shot. And look at the Spurs. And watch Brian Russell just run out. You have to get back. You always need a guy back. Usually, that's the guard who should be the guy back.
Pick and roll, Anderson, Maxwell. Quickly in the hands of Dominique Wilkins. No. Malone grabs it with authority and finds Hornacek. Utah running again. Now they come back to the half-court set. 8:12 to go, first quarter of play.
And on that time, you can see Utah tried to push it up. Transition D, they got back, and now Utah is into the clock. There's 12 seconds on the shot clock. That's exactly what the Spurs want tonight, is to get them deep in the shot clock, make this a low-scoring game to give them the best shot at winning the basketball game.
With three on the shot clock, off the mark, John Stockton. They want that to happen tonight.
Yeah, they would love for John Stockton to take threes and jumpers all night. That means he's not driving the lane and getting everyone else involved like that there.
Malone fouled by Cadillac Anderson, but it's almost as if there's nobody there.
Yeah, you obviously, the one guy you don't want driving to the basket is Karl Malone. You know, coaches teach or preach to their players to set up and get charges. There's not a lot of guys in the league who wants to get in the way of that freight train.
And Herrera's hiding behind the mask. Malone with a three-point play, and it's a seven-point Jazz lead now with 7:45 to go in the opening quarter. San Antonio, 5-19 on the road to complement their problems. Here's the pick and roll with Avery Johnson. There's the reach in. That's the third time already that they've reached in and knocked the ball loose.
It's really something smart to teach your players. If you're beat, you reach. And they do a great job. Take a look at it right here. Karl Malone is out of this play, but the last thing he said, or he thinks he can do, at least I can get my hand in there and reach, and he gets his hand on the ball and causes a close to a turnover. That's why they're so good defensively, because they not only move their feet and get the bodies in front, but if you do beat them, then you better protect the ball, because they're going after that also.
Cadillac Anderson was fouled after that loose ball. Avery Johnson, Vernon Maxwell, the only other two. We mentioned Sean Elliott's surgery today, successful 6 to 8 weeks. Robinson still out. Monty Williams, who's been playing very well now, has gone down. He's going to miss a week and a half.
Yeah, and I think that's the one. Obviously, they're all important, David Robinson being the key. But Monty Williams was coming into his own. You know, this is like a contract year for him, so this is important for him to play well. They didn't know what he could do, and there's silver linings and injuries, and sometimes that is their lining right now. They found a couple of guys. Carl Herrera is playing better basketball, and they found Monty Williams. So those are two good points about the injuries.
Dominique Wilkins gets a rest, and Jamie Fike, who's on the second of two 10-day contracts and playing for his career, is on the floor, and Avery Johnson fouls Karl Malone. I'll tell you what, he didn't back away, did he?
He will not back away. I don't think Avery looks at height. He looks at heart, and he thinks his heart is bigger than anyone else's heart, and that's what you see right there. I don't care if you're bigger than me. My heart's bigger than yours.
Greg Popovich talking with us this morning about what this man has meant to this team. Karl Malone shoots two.
Well, Avery's the heart and soul of the Spurs. He's not the best player on the Spurs. There's two or three or four guys better than him, but without that guy on the court, they don't have a leader. Not as far as basketball leadership and spiritual leadership. He gives it to you in both ways, and he's always leading. He's never relaxed. He is a, you know, they called him last year Little Hitler at times, because he's the guy that drives you crazy at times, but he drives you crazy in a good way.
13-6, and Avery Johnson brings it up. You tell me, he's pretty good with a pregame prayer, too.
Oh, he has some great ones.
An orator. Under 7 minutes to go in a seven-point Utah lead. Del Negro is on the floor for San Antonio. Off the bench now. And a foul is called. Time has also been called on the floor. When we come back, it'll be a Utah lead at 7.
Just because something hasn't been done before, does that mean it can't be done?
The Chrysler Concorde LXI. Cab forward design. Driver adaptive transmission. Independent touring suspension. Highest resale value. And now, receive $1,500 cash back. The Chrysler Concorde. built on the belief that anything can be done. What's new in your world?
Friday night, NBA on TNT. Watch the Bullets' huge front line try to stand in the way of Chicago. And Michael Jordan. Full Bullets Friday night at 8. The NBA's on TNT. Don't miss a game.
Take one.
I've always had fun playing. That's what drives me. I mean, I get joy out of just watching basketball. And anything can happen in the NBA. The players, they take it to another level. Every player at this level can do something totally amazing. It's exciting. It's fun. It's just a great game. I'm just a basketball junkie. I love the game.
Now, and for every championship season to follow, a new network dedicated to covering sports as never before. From CNN and Sports Illustrated comes CNNSI, the 24-hour sports news network.
But what about when you only have won 11 out of 47? Do you still lead? Do you back off from being the type of leader you are? No, you just keep leading. You keep staying focused and positive, and you keep demanding. And those are the true test of a leader, not just when things are going good, but when things are going bad.
And it has been a terrible season for San Antonio. Look at the games missed. David Robinson, Charles Smith, Chuck Person, Sean Elliott, and others. Among the top four, that's 28 points, or 28 rebounds per game, and 64 points per game.
Yeah, missing 64 points per game puts you in a big hole, and that's what they are in, is in a hole. You look at the injuries, and like I said in the opening, it's not because of lack of talent that this team is not doing well. It's because of injuries to key players.
Vic Vernon Maxwell in the backcourt now with Vinny Del Negro and Avery Johnson as Maxwell moves to a three. This one kicked back outside to John Stockton. He's picked up by Avery Johnson.
And for this team to have any chance tonight, Vernon Maxwell or Vinny Del Negro has to have a big game offensively.
That one knocked out of bounds by Utah. Shandon Anderson has checked in and is on the floor now for the Utah Jazz. Carl Malone. Now one official is going to overrule the other, and Brian Russell will throw it in. Will Perdue joins Carl Herrera.
Right.
Among the masked marvels. Oh, it's not funny for them, I know.
No, they don't like it. Guys were calling them Batman and Robin, and they were even having arguments in the locker room. Who was Robin?
Oh, goodness.
Everyone wants to be the leader.
Yeah.
No one wants to be Robin anymore.
And everybody's a comedian all of a sudden when they're not wearing the mask.
Yeah, that's true.
Underneath Avery Johnson, right in the hands of Brian Russell, who keeps control of the dribble. Now picks it up and finds Carl Malone. Ostertag Malone, Brian Russell, Stockton, and Shandon Anderson, younger brother of a former teammate of yours, Willie Anderson.
Yeah, has become a key part of this team. You know, it's funny when you talk to coaches, we're talking to Jerry Sloan this morning, they hate giving rookies too much credit. You can see him biting his lip, trying not to give the guy too much credit, but he did anyway. He really likes him. One of the things I was most impressed with what he said about Shandon Anderson is that he's a great listener, and that's really nice to see a rookie coming into the league listening.
Shandon Anderson missed 15 games with a stress fracture of his left foot. Ostertag can't hold on. That's another turnover for Utah. 13-6. Del Negro gets the pick from Perdue, finds Maxwell, who penetrates short off the glass into the hands of Malone.
You can tell Vernon Maxwell is trying to penetrate early. He has a lethal three-pointer when it's out. He's very streaky, but he's really trying to get to the paint right now and try to make things happen. It's not worked for him, but he's gotten there.
That's the second time in two possessions Ostertag has dropped it. And San Antonio finally hits after missing its last seven shots. It's Vinny Del Negro. Here's that transition defense. Nobody back.
Transition D. And you know what, Vern? They were back. They threw it anyway. You know, Utah does a lot of the things that the old Boston Celtics used to do. They'll run on you after makes. The best time to run on teams is after makes. You're feeling good about yourself. You just made a shot. You think it's time to party. You can't party. You have to get back.
Pick and roll underneath the Purdue. Knocked away by Carl Malone. Watch the left after the make.
Watch this after the make. Vinny Del Negro has his hand up. Shandon Anderson just runs down the court. And that was a great pass. He threaded it between two people. That was a quarterback pass right there, Vern.
Del Negro trying to explain it to Popovich.
Yes, he is. He was saying, I shot the ball. There should have been someone else behind me. And he's right. If you shoot the ball or if you drive at the guard spot, it's usually the other guard who has to get back.
Purdue makes two. And it's a five-point game at 15-10, 4:43 to go in the opening quarter. And timeout has been called.
Yeah, I think a 20-second timeout.
And Jerry Sloan and the Utah Jazz. Well, 1992, 1994, 1996 in the Western Conference Finals, yet to make it to the NBA Finals. I don't believe they'll ever get the respect they deserve until they finally make it that close.
They'll never get the respect. They're in a small market. They have two guys on their team. John Stockton every game breaks some kind of record in the NBA.
Right.
Every day I read John Stockton broke another record. I mean, look at where they rank in the league right now, and you have to give this team respect. The problem is no one reads about him. No one hears about him. Karl Malone, the fact that he hasn't been an MVP is almost shocking. He's had the numbers to be an MVP every year. His problem is he plays behind a guy named Michael Jordan. He plays at the same time that Michael Jordan plays, so he can't get one. He deserves one.
San Antonio, 3 of 12. And Utah 6 of 9 thus far. No surprise for Utah. They are the top field goal percentage team in the NBA. They have led the league in that division, in that category, rather, the last 2 years. Now, Shandon Anderson at the line mentioned he missed 15 games with that stress fracture. Just came back off the injured list at the end of January. Now, coming up, wouldn't you know it, all that noise going on in Orlando, and guess who's going to be on the tube tomorrow night? Portland at Orlando. Bob Neal and Chuck Daly will be there. Then the Bulls continue their road trip against Washington on Friday night, and the Lakers and the Rockets next Tuesday night.
Yeah, and the Bryant Hill thing, I think, surprised everyone. I think after Sunday, everyone knew it was going to happen. I was surprised that it happened. I thought that team had overachieved due to injury. I think this whole thing still comes back to Shaq. They miss Shaquille O'Neal. They know it more now than ever.
Along the baseline, Shandon Anderson. That one's touched last by Carl. Oh, it's saved in the corner. Three-pointer, no. And Del Negro gets the rebound, puts it out to Avery Johnson. 17-10. Jazz lead by that. Now here's Herrera backing in, finds Del Negro for three. Now, Vinny Del Negro, starter the last couple of years, off the bench as the sixth man. You like that role for him?
I love that role for him. He hates it. He hates not starting. He likes being a starter. He wants to be a starter. He wants to be viewed as a starter. But Vinny Del Negro has been playing great off the bench. It gives him an edge, and Vinny Del Negro is best when he plays with an edge. I like him coming off the bench because he gives them points, and he does a lot of little things to help the team win.
Here's Wilkins, no double team. Russell backs off, and Dominique Wilkins hits it. And it's a two-point game. 4 points for Wilkins now.
Now, the flow of this game is exactly the way Greg Popovich wants it. Nice and slow, no quick shot, except for that one. But that's a jump shot, and they don't mind that. This is exactly the tempo. They want to run. They just don't want the Jazz to run.
Karl Malone now 4 for 4, and it's back to a four-point edge. Del Negro scoops it out to Purdue, and he got it. Will Purdue for two. Now Purdue hurries back with Malone, and Isley pushes the ball up across the timeline. Malone, that's his first miss. And Wilkins with a rebound.
But again, it was a jump shot, no penetration. When you shoot jump shots, that means no one else is involved. You shoot it, everyone else is standing around watching. They would love to try to get the Jazz to stand around and watch.
Wilkins posting up Russell. Has it not? There's that reach again.
Another reach.
Boy, you said that at the shoot-around this morning. It's something they do better than any team in the league.
I've never seen a team reach as much. I don't think any other team does it as much. They have individual guys who do it, but every single guy on this team does it.
Shandon Anderson, Ostertag at 7-2. And then the dish underneath to Anderson. It's knocked away. Wilkins, fouled by Isley. 19-17 with 2:08 to go.
It's a timeout.
Dominique Wilkins with two of his four. It's a two-point game. First quarter from Utah.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome our own Jazz.
What happens when you don't just make something? You invent something.
The Chrysler Cirrus LXI. Cab forward design. Driver adaptive transmission. Speed sensitive steering. Fatigue reducing driver's seat. Car and driver's 10 best. And now, receive $1,000 cash back. The Chrysler Cirrus. The difference between just making something and inventing something. What's new in...
What's Marvin doing in the garage?
Helping Bobby make an electromagnet for his school science project.
Marvin knows about electromagnets?
Picked it up on the internet.
I didn't know Marvin was into computers.
He's not.
Finally, a way onto the internet for people who aren't way into computers. New Southwestern Bell Internet Service. With unlimited access, you can actually access.
This month, it's your choice. It's a smart choice. Pay-per-view. The NBA's newest coach is New York's biggest mouth. And as a team leader, she's a slam dunk. Bring home Eddie today. And a playboy hustler is a few strokes behind in the game to win the love of a beautiful doctor. Kevin Costner, Rene Russo, Tin Cup. This month, it's a hole-in-one on pay-per-view and Jones Intercable.
The Spurs' game plan tonight is to stop Utah's movement and make everyone stand around and let Karl Malone or John Stockton take jump shots. Look at this right here. The pass to Karl Malone, no cutting, guys standing around, jump shot. If they can do that tonight, they'll have a chance of winning the basketball game.
Greg Popovich. And let's check in with Dick Versace.
Well, Greg Popovich was just talking to his guys about how happy he was with the way the strategy was working. You know, Doc, the old college theory of if you're out man, pack in a 2-3 zone, that's essentially what's going on tonight.
Zone defense in the NBA?
Well, you can disguise it.
I'm shocked. Shocked, I tell you.
And that's what they're doing. It's really nice. They're saying beat us from the outside because you have more talent than us, and we're going to try to do something different tonight.
Jazz have tied it up. Now here's Isley. Stockton continues to rest. Here's the pick and roll. Malone off the iron. Purdue picked up the ball.
See, the problem is in that timeout, Jerry Sloan was telling them that also. He said, hey, guys, we're only shooting jump shots. Let's get a nice pick and roll here. Karl Malone roll to the basket and try to dunk the basketball. And that's how we'll win the basketball game.
Karl Malone off of Purdue's nose. 3 of 3 thus far at the line.
Now, Karl Malone's a testament, Vern, and you were telling us this yesterday of the percentage difference. And Malone, early in his career and later in his career, he's a testament that you can improve in free throw shooting.
Well, so are you, right?
Yeah, I had my troubles also. I was down in the 50s in college. You know, teams were fouling me in the second quarter.
I wonder if Shaq is listening to this.
I hope so. He has time.
Yeah, he does. Del Negro. Corey Alexander has come on, misses the three-pointer. Purdue gets a fresh start, however, for San Antonio. 21-19. It's Alexander replacing Avery Johnson. Here's Dominique Wilkins off the screen. Goes by Russell and takes the little soft runner for two.
Oh, what a great shot. You know, Dominique Wilkins is not a shooter. He's not a dunker, he's a scorer. He can score in any way. Banks, floaters, runners. That's why he has so many points. 27,000 points.
26,112.
Oh, that's amazing. That is an amazing number.
26,112 and 64 assists.
You know, the Grizzlies don't have that many points as a team.
Oster to Foster, rather, at the other end on the Oster tag. And that's going to be... The basket will go for Vinny Del Negro. Let's go back and take a look at Dominique.
Just look at one thing he does really well. He always moves. He never allows you to get a body on him. And then he takes just a tough shot. Every coach in the league just said bad shot until it went in. Then they say good shot. He gave Mike Patel a heart attack every game.
Did he give his point guard heart attacks?
After my first year, I was pretty comfortable with him. I knew half of them were going in.
San Antonio down by one, or up by one, and their first lead of the night at 24-23. Isley got away from Alexander.
Isley is such a solid player. He won't hurt you. He's not going to do anything spectacular. He's not going to dazzle you, but he won't hurt you. And that's what you want in a backup guard, a backup player in general.
Alexander, final 33 seconds of the first quarter, gets it back to Del Negro. Shandon Anderson guards him. There's a pick and roll with Herrera. Back to Herrera. Skip past all of the Brian Russell with one on the shot clock. Wilkins, no. 24-second violation.
Used way too much time. That play was set up for a two-for-one. They wanted to get the shot out before the 24-second clock obviously went off. They wanted to have another shot at it, and they let the 24-second clock go off. So that's obviously not good execution by the Spurs.
San Antonio has hit five of its last seven to climb above 40% for the game. This Jazz team, we talk a lot about how well they shoot the ball. They have limited their last two opponents to less than 40%, 38% in each case, against Dallas and Portland.
But they're a lot like the Bulls. Everyone talks about the Chicago Bulls offense, where they should be concentrating more on how good both of those teams are defensively.
Foster Trevor. That's seven turnovers in the first quarter for Utah, and that's helped San Antonio keep pace. Herrera will throw it in with 1.5 left in the quarter. Wilkins has time, but the shot is altered. Good defensive play by Shandon Anderson. Karl Malone has helped his team's cause with 13 first quarter points. Perfect at the free throw line. We've reached the end of one in Salt Lake. The Jazz by one.
For one entire year, you've waited. The wait is over.
I think I may have forgotten something.
Monaco to Malibu. Take a trip with TNT and feast your eyes on what you've been waiting for. Watch Sports Illustrated Swim 97, hosted by Rob Schneider.
Now I'm ready. Look out, ladies.
Premiering Saturday night at 9, exclusively on TNT.
Hot, hot.
Does everyone have email but you? AT&T can deliver it to you through the internet. AT&T, nobody makes it easier to catch the wave.
They'll have such strange eyes.
People leave the stand and say, wow, I never seen anybody pass the ball like that.
Is that all right?
He looks right through them as if they were glass.
This became known as the double jeopardy issue.
Your daughter has an American Express student card. She'll be able to get great deals on flights home.
It gives you more choices.
With that card, you can extend the payments.
It's very flexible.
You're going to get a reward point for every dollar you spend.
Our senior member card has a lower fee.
It gives you some more options.
I'm sure we've got a card that'll work for you.
Whoever you are, American Express helps you do more.
Neutrogena T-Gel Dandruff Shampoo, recommended number one by dermatologists. It works. Handles any type of dandruff symptom from mild to severe, controlling dandruff and other itchy, flaky scalp conditions. Neutrogena T-Gel Shampoo.
Welcome back to the Delta Center in Salt Lake City, Utah. The Utah Jazz with a one-point edge as they go after their sixth consecutive victory. And in the first period, the Jazz led by Karl Malone.
Yeah, Karl Malone is power and touch at the same time. And Vern, this is a guy, he plays defense, he runs the floor, he's big and powerful, he does it all. You look at his size, and you look at that body running down a court, that's not what you think would be running down the court at the speed that he runs over. That's a guy you do not want to get in the way of, I tell you that. I know that personally.
He has been double-teamed only twice tonight, 4 of 5 from the field, along with three assists, and three rebounds. And Malone will get a rest now as we begin the second quarter. And let's set the lineups for you for San Antonio: Herrera and Corey Alexander, Dominique Wilkins, Perdue, and Vinny Del Negro. And they're going to run a little isolation for Del Negro. Here comes Herrera to set the pick. Gets the return pass. Foster muscles him, and Herrera puts it up and in.
Oh, great shot. That's something Carl Herrera did in Houston, and in San Antonio, they have not seen enough of that. Now they have of late. That's another guy, as I talked about earlier, who is really starting to come in his own with minutes. Sometimes players need minutes to adjust to different teams. Carl Herrera is starting to respond.
Stockton got a big rest. He played only 7 minutes of the first quarter. He's back on the floor now. Antoine Carr is also there. And this loose ball foul goes against Utah. Del Negro and Herrera.
Just look at Utah. They wanted to trap, but stay and get back to your own man. They did everything right. One of the things you won't see Utah do is trap down on the post a lot. They didn't there, and it hurt them.
Alexander gets it in the hands of Dominique Wilkins. San Antonio outscored Utah 18-12 while John Stockton rested last half of the first quarter. Whoa, Herrera strong to the basket.
That's the play that they miss David Robinson the most, is on the pick and roll, because when he sets a pick, everyone pays attention.
Well, let's watch the pick and roll, Del Negro Herrera.
Well, there's a saying in the NBA, if it ain't broke, don't try to fix it. It worked two times in a row, and I will venture out to say, Vern, that we'll see it again.
You always operated under that philosophy, right?
Oh, I believe in that. If a play works, you keep running it. Don't save it for later. That guy might not be hot later, or the team might have made an adjustment. So you keep running it and make that team stop it. If you remember the Detroit Pistons with Vinnie Johnson, they had a play called the 15 play. And if they ran that pick and roll and he scored on the first time down, you'd break out in hives, because you knew for the rest of the night you had to guard that. You had to at least stop it two times in a row before they changed their mind.
Now let's see now if they run the pick and roll again. Now, there's Del Negro and Alexander. Looks underneath and throws it away.
Well, maybe they should have run it.
Yes. A one-point San Antonio lead. Stockton picked up by Corey Alexander in his second year. Here's Herrera with a switch. Now Herrera gets back. Shandon Anderson. Chris Morris is also on the floor now. Here's Anderson, fouled by Del Negro. That's the second foul on Vinny Del Negro.
Just watch John Stockton. You get out, you try to trap him, he splits it anyway and gets exactly what he wanted, and that's penetration and kick, and it draws a foul on Vinny Del Negro.
Vernon Maxwell back in now, replacing Vinny Del Negro. So it's Herrera, Cadillac Anderson back on the floor, Dominique Wilkins, Corey Alexander, and Vernon Maxwell. And for the Jazz, Greg Foster, Antoine Carr, Shandon Anderson, Chris Morris, and John Stockton. In the lane, foul on Anderson.
San Antonio first ball, Greg Anderson,
who quite obviously disagrees with the call.
Yeah, you on this team, if you're one of the big guys, you better get your hands ready, because the pass is coming, and they all do it. It's not just Stockton. He's the best at it, but everyone passes. Interior passing is a key component to this team's success.
This foul called on Corey Alexander, his second, fourth team foul of the quarter. And Chris Morris will inbound. Morris, in his second season in Utah last year as a starter, this year seldom used. He's averaging only 14 minutes per game. Antoine Carr. Nope. Alexander tracks it down. 1 point San Antonio lead, 9:45 to go first half. Jeff Hornacek getting set to come back on for Utah. Wilkins. They don't double, they reach, and they got it again. It's Stockton. Right side, Anderson. It would have been a great assist for John. 9:24 to go, first half. And here's Alexander. Maxwell. Herrera sets the pick. Right side to Wilkins. Reach around by Chris Morris. Let's take a look at the difference in doubling down and a reach in or a dig.
Yeah, watch this, and watch how when Dominique gets to the paint, he's not being doubled, but he has one, two, and even Shannon Anderson, who will get down there, three guys down on him. They're not a double team. A double team is when you turn your back, basically, on the guy you're guarding the traps. They don't do that. They reach and dig is the term that Jerry Sloan uses as a dig, and they do that very well.
Now, there was Utah in transition again, and it was knocked out of bounds by San Antonio. Jerry Sloan with his longtime assistant Phil Johnson by his side.
Another guy, it fits in perfect. He's another guy. He's one of the best coaches in this league that no one ever talks about as a great coach. It fits perfect with Utah. You know, no one talks about Malone as an MVP and Jerry Sloan as a great coach in this year.
Stephen Howard is on the floor now for Utah, and he got that rebound. And a fresh 24 for the Utah Jazz. They've yet to hit a field goal in this quarter, and they trail by one. Here's Howard.
Oh!
Got to keep your hands busy for the big guy, too, huh? That one. Taken away by Chris Morris. Cadillac Anderson.
Yeah, and that's a mistake. That's a high school mistake right there. The one thing you don't do if you're going out of bounds, either take the ball with you and try to throw it down to the other end of the court, but never throw it back inbounds out of your opponent's basket.
Dominique Wilkins, little jump step, and that'll be goaltending on Antoine Carr. Now watch the rebounding effort for Utah here.
Well, they're going to have a great shot at getting some boards tonight. And the reason is because the Spurs are scrambling, trapping. And when you trap, it gives guys free pass to the basket.
Antoine Carr, Stockton, guarded by Maxwell. Five on the shot clock. Now Stockton passes on the shot, gets it to Stephen Howard.
Wow, that was a creative shot. I thought he was going the other way with the basketball.
Stephen Howard, who was originally signed by this team back in the training camp days, was cut and signed by San Antonio.
Well, and he was with San Antonio when they beat the Jazz early in the year, and now he's playing with the Jazz against San Antonio. And he told me before the game, he said, never lose to a team that cuts you. So far, he's 1-0.
Stephen Howard from DePaul, where he played for Joey Meyer. And has now been signed to a full-term contract for the rest of the season here at Utah.
Jerry Sloan was telling us earlier in a meeting about Stephen Howard. He said he's a guy that deserves to be in this league. He's not a guy who has, when he was out of the league, just settled his butt. Here's a guy who went to the weight room, added some pounds, and worked on his game, and he deserves to be in the NBA, and that's why he's with the Jazz right now.
Maxwell misses both. And he's also 1-for-6 from the field, so it's been a long night. And you said that they needed him to really be an offensive force tonight.
Yeah, they need him or Vinny. Vinny did a good job when he was in, but they need one of those guys to make some shots for them. They need a creator besides just Dominique tonight. They need someone else.
Good defensive job by Maxwell then on Hornacek.
Well, that's the one thing you know he can do. He's a great defender. He's one of the guys, and you hate giving him this label that who was said to, can do a great job of Michael. Now, Michael has heard that. He'll get 50 the next time they play.
Antoine Carr, Hornacek, pick and roll with Carr. Dominique Wilkins guards Chris Morris. Now, the two guys who are subject to trade rumors. And Morris misses a scoop shot. Maxwell double teamed. They get it over to Corey Alexander for three. No, off the front edge. And here comes Utah. And there's John Stockton. No transition defense again.
And tonight, that's how the Jazz have scored most of their points. Is beating the Spurs back.
San Antonio looking for its first fast break points. They don't get them. Foul is called on Antoine Carr. Time has been called.
Bulls, Bullets, Friday night at 8. The NBA's on TNT.
Place body on chassis as shown in figure 7.
It started with a childhood memory.
Well, it's got to be part retro.
Part modern.
We got to be nuts.
And at the Chrysler Corporation, it grew into an idea for a car so outrageous, we just had to build it.
Well,
not exactly for everyone, is it?
That's kind of the point.
It's how we do things at the Chrysler Corporation. It's how we build great cars and great trucks.
This month, the choice is yours with pay-per-view. In the darkest reaches of the jungle lies a terrifying secret. A deadly experiment where man and beast become one. The Island of Dr. Moreau. And share the wonder as one shining moment sends an ordinary man on an incredible journey. John Travolta, Phenomenon. Two extraordinary features on pay-per-view and Jones Inner Cable.
This month, Jones Inner Cable gets personal. Discover the passion that made him a leader on this biography premiere. And take an intimate look at one of today's most diverse entertainers on this Lifetime original. Be a part of Black History Month on Jones Inner Cable.
Ernie Johnson in Atlanta. The New York Knicks took a five-game winning streak into their game against the Suns tonight. Jason Kidd making his first start since returning from the collarbone injury. 12 points in the first half and 7 assists. He hits Kevin Johnson for 3. The Suns hit 8 out of 10 from beyond the arc in the first half. And they are giving New York all kind of trouble at Madison Square Garden. 64-53 is the third period score. More on that at halftime tonight. Now let's go back to the Delta Center to Vernon Dock. Guys.
All right, EJ, it's all broadcaster turned coach, Doc.
Don't say that.
Start that rumor.
Oh, boy.
And Jason Kidd, of course, missed 22 games. But he can be a valuable addition to that Phoenix team.
Yeah, he really can, especially with Kevin Johnson saying he's going to retire after this year, something I personally don't understand. I think Kevin Johnson is having a great year. He has had a lot of injuries, but he's only been in the league, I think this is his 10th year. Him retiring, to me, I don't get it. I think he has 4 or 5 good years left in his body.
Well, Greg Popovich worried about his transition defense tonight. Utah was 7. Baskets and none for San Antonio at their end.
Well, he wasn't worried about them. He didn't think they'd get a lot, but
right.
He didn't want them to get any either. And Utah has 7 already. That can't make him happy.
As John Stockton in the last 2 games missed only 3 from the field. And tonight has already missed 3. He's looking for his first. Stockton 14 of 17 from the field in the last 2 games. And Hornacek also scoreless thus far. He's now 0 for 5. Here's Johnson in the corner to Maxwell, short. The offensive board, and Dominique Wilkins is fouled as he goes up. And let's check in with Dick Brassais.
Well, Greg Popovich is very concerned about the transition defense. He was explaining to his guys, look, they're running out on the shooter. That means the opposite deep man has to get over and cover. You can't expect the shooter to get back and cover as well. So he's saying, we're all responsible for it. Jam the rebounder if you have to, but let's not give up any easy baskets.
Yeah, and that's right. When you look at who's guarding who, right now the Spurs have guys, the 2-man is playing the 3 position, the point is playing the 3 or 4. They have so many different positions, so many guys in different positions. They are having a tough time finding out and realizing where to go. They have to get back out to it. It always is the weak side guy. You're shooting the jump shot, you can't get back. And they're running out.
Stockton underneath, what a beautiful play. Oh, and there's Malone, who takes time to chat with the guys who paid a lot of bucks to sit in the first row down there.
You know, it's funny, when guys do that, you look at this cut, and you're going to see this a lot tonight. And start mugging to the cameras. Guys on the other team really don't appreciate that or like that. The problem is Carl Malone. There's not a lot you can do about it. So I think with him, people forget and just let it go.
Sure. Wise.
It's like the bully kicking sand on your face. If he's a bully and tougher than you, not a whole bunch you can do about it.
Take the sand.
And keep walking.
Yeah, absolutely. Back to a 2-point Utah lead. Maxwell in the pick and roll with Jamie Fike, who's back on the floor now, number 14. Wilkins, strong. He's already got 13 points. Fike has the rebound, puts it up, he'll go to the free throw line.
And Fike is doing exactly what they put him in the game for. Be a banger, get some loose balls, get some rebounds, and try to score. If you're around the basket and draw fouls, that's exactly what he just did.
Jamie Fike from Michigan State, a second-round draft pick of the 76ers, cut. And he played three games with Charlotte in January. He's just the San Antonio compliment to Stephen Howard, a guy who's trying to get a shot in the league.
Yeah, he's just trying to catch on. You know, you said it earlier, Vern. He's playing for his life right now. He wants a spot on the team, and he just didn't want a 10-day. He wants to remain on the team. And basically what he gives you a big body. He's a banger. He has a decent shot from 10 feet and in. And he's willing to play and fight anybody out on the court. You like guys like that on your team. You like fighters on your basketball team.
And like Stephen Howard, Jamie Fike spent some time with the Oklahoma City Cavalry in the CBA this year. He is nearing the end of his second 10-day contract with San Antonio, so a decision will be made shortly. Here's Stockton driving and dishing to Malone. And Karl Malone's going to go back to the free throw line.
And two times in a row now, Utah has made a concerted effort to take the ball down the lane. Gary Sloan has told his team enough of these jump shots. We know you guys can shoot. Let's get it to the bucket.
Okay, you got a kid from Gonzaga University and a kid from Louisiana Tech. And they come here, and between the two of them, they have played 1,978 regular season games. How many have they missed? Four each. Yeah, that's extraordinary.
Yeah, that's extraordinary. That not only have they not missed games, but they played well in all the games that they played in. So, you know, John Stockton, I remember the day, I remember where I was at when he was drafted. I was in my mother-in-law's and father-in-law's house in Milwaukee, and they drafted John Stockton. I said, who is that guy? I've never heard of him. I thought Utah had lost their minds. And look what he's coming. He has almost every record at guard in NBA history. He's one of the greatest guards ever played a game.
Well, when you've got Wilt Chamberlain saying at the All-Star game that he would love to have played with John Stockton, it's pretty high praise.
Yeah, when you have Wilt Chamberlain praising anybody, it's high praise because it doesn't come easily from Wilt.
Karl Malone gets another free throw. Lane violation, and he sinks this one.
Karl Malone comes very close to that rule, 10 seconds. You know, you remember last year in the playoffs, Seattle, the fans start counting the 10-second count, and it bothered him. So, obviously, you won't hear it tonight, but if you're on the road, if they're on the road, I'm surprised more crowds don't do that to him.
Off the dribble, Vernon Maxwell, wonderful, and he gets it to fall. Oh, boy, what a terrific play. 38-38, 5 minutes to go in the first half. The tempo, the pace of this game, to San Antonio's liking.
Exactly the way they want it, and they're getting jump shots.
Air ball from Chris Morris. Nice assist to Ostertag.
I don't know if that was an air ball or a pass. I think in the middle of his jump shot, he saw the guy under the basket and decided to pass it.
Do you really?
Well, that's what he's going to tell us either way.
So I wonder.
We should go with it.
He's got you in his pocket, huh? Avery Johnson, no foul. My goodness.
Well, John Stockton got away with one there.
Right side to Chris Morris, guarded by Wilkins. Looks underneath to Malone. Anderson's got him. Here's Malone. Oh, boy.
Oh, man. And that was set up by Chris Morris. He backed the ball up. He gave his team some spacing, gets it in and cuts, and you'll see Utah cutting all night.
Karl Malone with four assists along with everything else. Four-point lead.
The NBA on TNT is brought to you by Jeep, makers of the Jeep Grand Cherokee, Cherokee, and Wrangler, and by Nestle Butterfinger BBs.
Mouth-bending blast you get from a Butterfinger, but just want a little. Now you can have it with Butterfinger BBs. Bite-sized bursts of crispity-crunchity Butterfinger that give you blast after blast. Have a Butterfinger blast from Nestle.
Worried that no one will visit your website? AT&T can drive customers right to your door. AT&T, nobody makes it easier to catch the wave.
The night is beautiful, so the faces of my people. The stars are beautiful, so the eyes of my people. Beautiful also is the sun. Beautiful also are the souls of my people. Like this poem, the work of many African Americans has shaped my life. I have been inspired by the achievements of Black Americans in everything from arts and sciences to human and civil rights. February is Black History Month. Take time to learn more about our rich heritage.
Just before the break, Vernon Maxwell with the ball, Jeff Hornacek guarding him.
And one of the advantages the Spurs do have is in this matchup as far as quickness. Vernon Maxwell has a quickness advantage over Jeff Hornacek, and he can get to the basket. And that's exactly what he did, and they're going to need that. Now, on the other end is Dominique Wilkins. And if you see here, the pass goes in to Karl Malone, and Dominique Wilkins right there will lose eye contact with his man. And that's a cardinal rule on defense. And if he wants to get to Utah, Vern, he's going to have to make sure he plays better defense than on that play right there.
42-38. Phil Johnson looks concerned.
Yeah, they both do.
Oh, boy. What a duo. Johnson, Jerry Sloan. 4:08. Before the break, Avery Johnson, pick and roll with Dominique Wilkins, takes the jumper, no. Malone, Stockton hurries down the floor, but they'll get into the half-court set now.
You can see it every time. Karl Malone got that rebound and looked right up court. He wanted to advance the basketball. Good job by the Spurs that time getting back.
Hornacek, cans one. And it's a six-point lead. Largest lead in the first quarter was seven by Utah. Maxwell. Three and a half to go before the halftime break. Purdue is back on the floor. Maxwell from way outside. Air ball.
And the tempo is starting to change a little bit. You can see Utah running and beating him down the court right there. You can see the tempo.
And Karl Malone goes flying into the photographers. There will be no kick, I promise you that. Instead, there's a gentle pat on the back of the head and a smile. Well, there's a difference in demeanor.
Watch Karl Malone run the floor. I mean, this is a guy who's only missed four games in his career, running the floor, taking out cameramen, doing everything. His speed at his size is amazing. It'd been interesting for him to play football. What position? He would have been a tight end.
Oh,
Keith Jackson.
Yep.
The first guy that comes to mind. Yeah, look at that there, Vern. You know, balance on this team. The 23 from the key guys, 22 from the rest of the team. And this is, in my opinion, a reason why they have a great shot this year at making it to the finals.
Malone has already attempted 10 free throws. More significantly, he has made every one of them. And the lead is the largest of the first half. The lead is eight. Vinny Del Negro getting ready to come back for San Antonio. There's the reach from Stockton and a foul called on Brian Russell. Saturday night, don't miss some of the world's top models as TNT brings you the premiere of Sports Illustrated Swimsuit Special. Get a behind-the-scenes look at the making of the much-anticipated annual swimsuit issue beginning at 9, only on TNT.
No comment, Vern. No comment on that.
Nor from me. Wilkins made both, and the lead is six. Hornacek. Wilkins had his back turned.
Back turn on the defense and great offense by Jeff Hornacek. That was a great move right there.
Lead is eight. Avery Johnson, Wilkins. Del Negro back on the floor. Stockton goes for the steal and steps back. Now the pick and roll from Purdue and Johnson. There's Will Purdue as Ostertag goes back, gets him. And off the glass, here comes Utah running again. Boy, they do run after made baskets.
I tell you what, they try to step it right back down you. You have to pay attention almost more on made baskets than you do on miss.
Oh, Malone again with the follow-away. 22 first half points for Karl Malone. And the lead is back at 8 as we near the 2-minute mark.
2 minutes remaining, 2 minutes.
Del Negro, Purdue. Malone with a clean block.
Weak side help. Great weak side help by Karl Malone.
Ball was kicked, fresh 24, and Utah will take it out of bounds and watch Malone.
Well, this is probably the most improved part of Karl Malone's game, and that's that jump shot. Early days, you could let him shoot it. Now you can't. And this is another reason Utah was so good. That's a great pass by Vinny. Most teams, that's a dunk. On Utah, that's help defense.
Underneath, John Stockton off the glass for two more. And the first double-digit lead of the night.
You can see the tempo change a little bit. Utah's getting into their offense quicker. The Spurs are taking more time. The last three or four times down the court, the Spurs have shot the ball with about 3 or 2 seconds on the shot clock.
And it's at 6 right now. Here's Dominique Wilkins, fouled by Brian Russell. It doesn't help San Antonio's cause any, Doc, that Utah has hit its last 7 shots.
No, but most of those shots have been layups or close baskets, and that's something Greg Popovich did not want. He wanted them to shoot jump shots, and they're not right now. The only jumper they've had to make is Karl Malone's turnaround, which is almost like a layup.
Now, coming up on the Nike Halftime Report, Ernie Johnson and Cheryl Miller are joined by Reggie Miller in our Atlanta studios. We're going to try and get Reggie a clothing contract before the week is out.
Yeah, Cheryl should give him one of her outfits.
No, that only happens in Chicago.
Good point.
Not in Indiana.
That's a good point.
It would not go well in Indianapolis. Well, they'll talk with both Don Nelson and John Calipari about the trade last night. Randy Galloway in the morning news said this morning in his lead column, Don Nelson did what every general manager has dreamed of doing at some point in his career. He fired the whole team.
And he fired them all, too. I tell you, Don Nelson did not like not the talent on the Mavs. He didn't like the attitudes on the Mavs. And the only way to exercise that is by exercising it off, and he did it. Now, you just hope that something happens good. I think the key to that trade is Sean Bradley. If Sean Bradley plays well or turns out to be as good as people thought he could be, then it's a decent trade. If not, it's not a very good trade for Dallas. Right now, it looks one-sided.
Now, Nelly spent his hibernation on the island of Maui. I think somebody spiked his guava juice. Boy, he got active when he got to Dallas, didn't he? As a matter of fact, there's the block underneath. Shandon Anderson with the block. Final 50 seconds. Here's Malone. Fouled by Corey Alexander.
And Corey Alexander looked like a deer in headlights right there. He looked up and saw Karl Malone running at full speed right at him, and he didn't like what he saw, and I don't blame him.
He is having an enjoyable first half. The last San Antonio road win, and they are 5-19, came at Dallas last week. And it was a thumping the Spurs put on the Mavericks. And Greg Popovich was telling us this morning, he thinks that's when Don Nelson took one look at his team and said, I don't like these guys.
That was one of his first looks at the team. You know, it was right after the All-Star break, the Spurs came in. Vernon Maxwell had a huge game that night, made 8 threes. But Don Nelson looked at that team, and he didn't like the effort. And that has been a constant with the Mavs over the last couple of years. And either you try to change it with your coach or you try to change it in the players. And Don Nelson went the player route.
23 touches, only 4 double teams. And Malone in the first half has had an output that would satisfy most guys for the full 48 minutes.
Yeah, and again, on the Dallas situation, you know, they've had enough coaches over the last 4 years, so at some point, the finger has to go to the players. I think Don Nelson has understood that, and that's why he made the moves.
Will Purdue, here comes Utah after a made basket. It is Shandon Anderson.
They're putting on a clinic right now in transition offense, and I don't know if a good transition defensive team can get back. They're getting that ball up so quick, and the thing I'm most impressed with, you don't hear the dribbling sound. All you hear is passing. The dribble comes when it's going to the basket. You see the ball in the air and bodies running.
That sounds like a what's up, Doc, to me.
That is.
Popovich said this morning he was really concerned about his transition defense.
Now we understand why.
They are pushing the ball up court. Everyone talks about Utah and the pick and roll and get into their sets. I think some teams better start worrying about their transition offense because they're really pushing the ball right now.
Alexander guarded by Stockton. Final 25 seconds, first half. The lead is 12. Thrown away.
Yeah, I tell you what, you look at this team, tough turnover for him. San Antonio's hung in the game, but right now, Utah's making a run, and not good run for San Antonio. They want to get this a little closer to halftime. Unfortunately, they're not going to get any shots left. There, Utah's going to take the last shot this quarter.
Karl Malone with a rest at the start of the second quarter since he came back on the floor. It's a 25-12 Utah lead. Shandon Anderson. At the other end, Anderson knocks it out of the hands of Dominique Wilkins. 1.2 left on the clock.
And that's exactly what Greg Popovich wanted on that play there. Knocked out of bounds, not much time. Now they get a shot at the basket right under.
14-0 transition points tonight.
And tempo has changed, and that's why this lead has changed and gone up to a 14-point lead is because of the tempo. It was a slow tempo for a quarter and a half, and now it's in the Jazz favor.
Alexander. The last half of the second quarter belonged to the Utah Jazz. Dominique Wilkins has helped keep San Antonio within shouting distance, but Karl Malone with a terrific first two quarters. 24 points. And the Utah Jazz lead by 14. Back to Atlanta in a moment.
NBA.com. Log on and get connected.
Year after year, generation after generation, this familiar vehicle has gone through change after change, improvement after improvement. But one thing remains the same. It's still a Jeep. It's how we do things at the Chrysler Corporation. It's how we build great cars and great trucks.
In the world of racing, you'd be hard-pressed to find more pounding, more rattling, and more punishment than the SCORE Desert Championship Series. It ain't pretty, but it's the extremes of off-road racing that help us build our longest-lasting battery ever, the Duralast battery from AutoZone. A battery so tough, so dependable, we back it with a 2-year free replacement guarantee. The next time you hit the open road, don't settle for anything less. The Duralast battery, power you can depend on.
I think everyone in the arena thought he was going to pass.
My uncles played ball. My father played ball. Basketball is in my blood. I'm still a leader in my own small way.
Oh, I'm the king. Oh, I'm the king.
Make no mistake. You are the king. And the king lives in the castle. And his word is law.
That's just a normal move. What are you talking about? Oh, Coach, come on. There's nobody on the floor. How can you take me out? Maybe you need to go back to coaching Catholic school.
After 24 minutes, Jazz by a couple of touchdowns over the Spurs. 60-46. The mailman's got 24. In Atlanta, it's time for the Nike Halftime Report. Ernie Johnson, Cheryl Miller, joined tonight by her brother, Reggie Miller, in town for the Hawks game tomorrow night. We begin tonight with the news out of Orlando, where Brian Hill was fired today. The Magic a game under 500, 0-5 since the All-Star break. Now, at the break, GM John Gabriel praised the job Hill had done without Shaquille O'Neal with all the injuries the team has endured. 9 days later, he cut him loose after hearing from the players.
As far as, players pushing a coach out, I do not see it that way. You know, these players were unified in their thoughts. Naturally, some of them different thoughts and different perspectives on the situation, but felt collectively, in order to move forward, this would be their recommendation.
Well, I don't think this is anything that's new in the NBA, quite honestly, but certainly in the ideal situation, I would have preferred it more if one or several of my players had come to me and discussed any problems that we might have had, but that's not always the nature of young people today.
You know, Reggie, 2 weeks ago tonight, you and the Pacers went down to Orlando, and those guys beat you by 24, and they're in the process of winning five in a row.
You know, I was wondering, where was all this losing when we went down there? Because they looked pretty good when they played us. I think everyone was in sync. Penny had just coming back, and I guess that honeymoon when he came back was still kind of there, and then all of a sudden they go down and lose five in a row. They look pretty good against us, though.
But players talk, I mean, before the game, and you'll see somebody. Any indication to you that, hey, things are sinking fast in Orlando?
Well, you know, a few plays out there on the court. I'm not going to mention no names. A few guys were a little distressed they weren't getting the ball. But, I mean, that's something.
A few or one?
There was a few of them out there. But I can understand where they were coming from because it was a new situation for everyone. Penny was just coming back. Guys were used to getting no shots when he was out, so. You know, some of them were a little bit distressed.
Now, Richie Adubato's got the reins right now.
Yeah.
For the time being. Where's John Gabriel going from here?
Well, I think the work begins for John from here on out, finding not a good replacement, but a great replacement. And already the rumor mill is working overtime. Our distinguished Chuck Daly's name has been tossed around. I don't think you're going to be able to get him off the golf course. Bob Hill, of course, which would really fit into the style of play of a Brian Hill. But the name that really surprised me was Rick Pitino. Here is a guy that supposedly is looking at maybe leaving Kentucky. This would be a great situation for him to step right into.
You know, I talked to Chuck Daly about a half hour ago, and he had just gotten in from the golf course and said, no, nobody's talked to him, but he had 15 messages waiting for him when he got home. Here's some news out of Dallas. Now, Don Nelson has not made a trade today. Resting, I guess, after last night's nine-player deal with New Jersey. The Mavs sent Jim Jackson, Chris Gatling, George McLeod, Sam Cassell, and Eric Montross to the Nets for Sean Bradley, Robert Pack, Khalid Reeves, and Ed O'Bannon. I think they call it house cleaning.
I really like players. First of all, they want to be here in Dallas. I think that's important to make a change because those players obviously didn't. The old ones didn't want to be here. You could tell by their performance on the court. You want players to play this game for the right reasons. The right reasons are simply to win games and and enjoy and love the game of basketball. That truly wasn't happening here, so a major change was needed.
Rich, what did you think when you heard the word about this nine-player swap?
Well, if I'm John Calipari, I'm licking my chops. Now, I'm glad we're done playing New Jersey. That's first and foremost what I'm going to say. But getting an all-star in Gatling, a future all-star in Jimmy Jackson, he came out ahead on this deal.
And what's Nelly up to?
I'm really trying to figure that out. I can understand that Nelly really wanted to try to rebuild in a new team and build a better attitude. But, you know, you're looking at a team that really right now has a lot of very, very complimentary players.
They're not done, though.
You don't think they're done?
There's no way Gil, Kittle, and Jimmy Jackson.
How do you lure someone of a marquee value to a team that is basically, you know, it's not a very good team?
Well, it has been done. I think John Calipari is in the wheeling and dealing business now. He's through with all that going out and recruiting players. I think now he knows what the NBA business is all about, and I think he can get the job done. Mm-hmm.
Tuesday night with the Millers continues here on the Nike Halftime Report in just a second. We'll have some highlights for you. Jason Kidd in the starting lineup of the Phoenix Suns tonight. And working at the Garden in New York. A whale of a game in New York. Highlights coming right up.
When's the last time you saw one of these? It's funny that people don't think twice about regular visits to their dentist or family doctor, but don't see an eye doctor until there's a problem. The fact is, an annual eye exam from a Pearl-affiliated doctor of optometry is important, whether or not you wear glasses or contacts. It can help detect a serious vision problem early when it's most treatable, and I promise it won't hurt a bit.
Nobody cares for eyes more than Pearl.
Life is empty, torturous.
I yearn wanting more.
Wanting more.
There's a burning from within.
Here's a tip. Eat something.
I recommend the new Extreme Carvers from Boston Market, like the chicken cheesesteak. Juicy, slow-roasted chicken, peppers, and onions smothered in four ooey-gooey cheeses. Now get a free side and a free drink when you buy an Extreme Chicken Cheesesteak, only at Boston Market.
Well, that burning from within, it's called hunger.
If you love the mouth-bending blast you get from a Butterfinger, but just want a little, now you can have it with Butterfinger BBs. Bite-sized bursts of crispity-crunchity Butterfinger that give you blast after blast. Have a Butterfinger blast from Nestle.
Does everyone have email but you? AT&T can deliver it to you through the Internet. AT&T. Nobody makes it easier to catch the wave.
When planning your next vacation, let the team of car rental experts at Hertz and AAA Travel Services put you in the right rental car. Hertz, AAA's preferred car rental partner. Hertz offers exclusive savings and added benefits just for AAA members. For details, call the Hertz AAA desk at 1-800-654-3080.
Travel with someone you trust.
AAA Travel Services.
And we welcome you back to the Nike Halftime Report. That is Jason Kidd in the starting lineup for the first time since the collarbone injury and a three-pointer. And then he's working on Charlie Ward. 15 points at last report for Jason Kidd. He had 12 of those in the first half. They were up 70-54 were the Suns at Madison Square Garden, and New York comes back. Ewing's got 29. They finished the third with an 18-2 run. Allen Houston with the roll, so they went to the fourth quarter tied at 72. Shade over 7 minutes to go, 84-81, the Phoenix lead over the Knicks, who have won five in a row. Miami's won nine in a row, trying to make it 10, and it's 85-73 in the fourth quarter. Tim Hardaway having another big game. He had 26-3 and just schooling Allen Iverson yet again. Denver and Chicago at the United Center. It is 54-41. The Bulls have won three in a row. Michael had 10 points in the first quarter, also, though, had three fouls. Let's talk about the Indiana Pacers since we have Reggie Miller here. We're not used to seeing.
Are you sure you guys want to talk about us?
Well,
so
are you sure you want to?
Everyone
hey, you're number nine in the East. That's never the case at this point on the calendar. Right. What's up? What's not clicking with the Pacers?
Well, I think we've just about used every excuse in the book, from injuries, the chemistry not being there. I read an article today where Coach Brown was taking a lot of the criticism in USA Today. It could be a combination of all those things, but basically, it comes down to the players going out there and actually playing the game. We've been up and down a little bit. We've gotten the big fella back. He hasn't been back 100%, and then Derek McKee goes down. So injuries have played a part in it a little bit. But I think overall, you know, we're right behind Orlando. We're half a game behind them, and hopefully they'll keep sliding. And we can move on up and try to get into the playoffs.
Reggie, it's always kind of a question about Mark Jackson and being traded in the offseason. And you know what, they were hoping that Travis Best would be able to step up, but did it really hurt the team when Haywood Workman went down with his knee injury after the season?
Well, at the time, Travis was struggling a little bit, and that was Haywood's first game starting, and he blows his knee out. And if anyone really knows the team, it was Haywood Workman, and it hurt to have Mark be traded. You know, he knew the players well, and it was a gamble on our part. We wanted to develop Travis, and we're doing that. It's unfortunate that he's been thrust into this role, but I think in time, getting the point guard situation under control will be okay.
You know, let me break from the Pacers for just a second. One of my favorite stories from the Miller household is the night that Cheryl went for 105 in a game. Do you recall the night she had 105 in a game, right?
Yes, because I thought I was the big wood when I had 39. You know, I was going to give her, blow her chops a little bit getting into the car because she played in the opposite gym and we played at home. And I get in the car, I'm like, you know, I had 39. You're like, what did you have? And my dad's laughing. I'm like, all right, now, what'd she have? You know, a normal game for Cheryl in high school was maybe 45, 50. So I'm thinking, oh, wow, she had 60. You know, that'd have been, and kept laughing, no, go up. 70. Keep going up. And that was outrageous. Okay, 90. You keep going up. I'm like, stop the car. Let me out of here. 105.
You'll be happy to know that she never tells anybody that story except me. Reggie, thanks for being here tonight.
Thank you.
And good luck tomorrow night against the Hawks.
Thank you.
Reggie Miller, our guest here on the Nike Halftime Report. A lot of love in this studio. Back to wrap things up in just a second.
You know that feeling you get with ordinary contact lenses? It's the buildup of dirt and deposits.
Tell them about the free contacts.
I'm getting there, hon. That's why I called Johnson & Johnson at 1-800-701-6100 and got a free trial pair of AccuView from my doctor. AccuView always gives me the comfort of fresh new lenses.
They know about the free pair?
They know. AccuView is the lens doctors prescribe most often.
Mr. Curtis?
Even for you.
They know where to call?
They know. Change to AccuView for more comfortable contacts.
Your daughter has an American Express student card. She'll be able to get great deals on flights home.
It gives you more choices.
With that card, you can extend the payments.
It's very flexible.
You're going to get a reward point for every dollar you spend.
Our senior member card has a lower fee.
It gives you some more options.
I'm sure we've got a card that'll work for you.
Whoever you are, American Express helps you do more.
Remember, later tonight, inside the NBA, Craig Sager sat down with Brian Hill and his wife, Kay, about the firing in Orlando today. You'll hear that conversation on Inside the NBA. Third quarter coming up from Utah.
Good morning.
Morning.
What can I do for you?
Two copies, please.
Yesterday, Evelyn Hartwell fulfilled a dream. A dream big enough to change her life, small enough to hold in her hand. She got the keys to her first home.
Thank you.
By the way, congratulations.
For a free guide that can help you get a home of your own, call the Fannie Mae Foundation. We're showing America a new way home.
And this is a guy thing, right?
Schick brings you the shaving system for sensitive skin.
Is this a sensitive part?
Designed to give a smooth shave with less irritation. Schick. Tracer FX.
You the sensitive type? I like that.
Designed for the man with sensitive skin. Schick Tracer FX.
Behind every great woman, there's a story to be told.
I have no regrets at all. I regret the things I didn't do.
Their defining moments. What they achieved. Who they loved. Why they struggled. How they survived.
And say simply, with hope, good morning.
Women who have changed the world. Stories that will change your life. Intimate Portrait.
The Simpsons are expecting, so they came to Cable Dahmer Chevrolet Geo looking to trade up for a new Chevrolet with a little more room, but they still wanted something sporty. With Cable Dahmer's 8.5 acres of cars, trucks, and vans, plus special good neighbor financing, they had no problem finding all the space they need. Come see us at Cable Dahmer Chevrolet Geo Mazda on the Miracle Mile, Nolan Road, Independence.
This program is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the National Basketball Association. Any publication, reproduction, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the National Basketball Association is prohibited.
We are in the capital of the state of Utah, Salt Lake City, at the Delta Center, where we have reached halftime, and the Utah Jazz are up by 14. Over the injury-decimated San Antonio Spurs. A moment ago, Dick Versace with Greg Popovich.
Hey, Pop, you know, pretty good strategy. You pack things in at work pretty well, but Malone got away on you with the single coverage plus the transition defense.
Well, you know, the guys, you know, that are out there are doing a good job in a lot of ways, but the transition defense is the worst in the history of the world.
Well, what can you do about it? How about putting somebody on the ball? Because you're getting hurt on made baskets.
Well, we're getting hurt in transition. Everybody is going to the board for some strange reason. You know, we're not a good offensive rebounding team, and we've got people totally mismatched down there on the board where they're supposed to be getting back. So that's what we spent our halftime on. On the easy buckets we gave in transition, that's the basketball game here tonight, and we can't afford to do that, obviously, in the current situation. So that's the deal, transition D.
Well, you got them playing hard, Pop. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right, Greg Popovich. Take a look at this. 14 transition points, fast break baskets for Utah, Zibola for San Antonio.
Well, you knew San Antonio was not going to get a lot. They don't want to score too quickly. They would like to get some easy buckets off steals, but you have to limit Utah from getting those. And Greg Popovich made a great point. If we're not going to rebound, we should at least get back. The one thing this team has done over the last 3 or 4 years is they played hard. And tonight, they played hard, but they're not getting back. And that's a big concern for Popovich because he said either we have to rebound so they can't run or we have to get back.
You have seen a lot of transition defenses. Is this indeed the worst in the history of the world?
I don't think it's the worst in the world. I would tell you right now, Don Nelson would probably say the last game before this trade, they had the worst in the world.
And those guys are all New Jersey fans.
Yes.
Well, Dominique Wilkins, subject of some trade speculation. You heard Dick Versace say before the game started, Dominique might be headed toward Utah. We just had an interesting chat with Larry Miller, the owner of the Utah Jazz.
Yeah, but he said he can't say too much because we're media and we might bring it up on the air.
possible. We would never indulge in rumor.
No, we wouldn't. No, we wouldn't. And
suffice it to say that Larry Miller, the owner of the Jazz, said he thought Dominique Wilkins had a terrific first half.
Yeah, he did. He said, boy, he looks young.
Maxwell gets the pick. Here's Herrera, left side, Avery Johnson with the jumper. No. Chased down by Brian Russell. Here comes John Stockton, 6 assists, not many points in the first half. And Hornacek, guarded by Maxwell, a 14-point lead at the half. Malone fouls, and he goes back to the free throw line where he has been perfect tonight. As a matter of fact, Utah has been perfect tonight.
Yeah, they're 20 for 20 for the night, and he's going to get another chance to increase that. It's interesting, one of the changes the Spurs made coming out of the halftime, you can see they decided to front the post for the first time. Utah was too good for that. They're so good. Right when they fronted, Karl Malone is on the free throw line already. They, I'm sure, have seen every possible way of trying to stop Karl Malone, and they make adjustments probably quicker than any other team.
That's the first miss of the night, first legal miss. Malone had one clang in the first half, but there was a lane violation. San Antonio has done well at the line tonight. They're 17 of 19.
So it's a good onus for the league, a good free throw shooting clinic going on right now.
Dale Harris is watching this and saying, if only.
Dale Harris, Phil Jackson, because Scottie Pippen's not shooting well from the line.
Right.
Chris Webber is shooting awful from the line. There's a lot of great players right now not doing a good job from the free throw line. But everyone talks about Shaq. We should talk about them all.
Herrera, good ball movement to Cadillac Anderson, and then a shot is too strong.
He was anticipating contact from Karl Malone, and instead of looking at the basket, he was looking at Karl Malone. That's why he missed that shot.
Now here's Malone. Finds Hornacek underneath. What a pass.
Again, they've seen it all. They tried to trap that time. Hornacek sees it right away. He drives, cuts to the basket, and he gets a layup. This team have seen all the defensive adjustments, and they react to him really quick.
Traveling. Stockton, Malone. You don't say one without the other.
No, or any of these guys. They just cut. Hornacek just cuts to the basket, gets an open bucket. They read each other and feel, and they play off of Stockton and Malone.
Here's Stockton with a cut. With a scoop shot. Nope. Ostertag is fouled. And the 7 foot, 2 inch, 280 pounder from Duncanville, Texas will go to the line. It's amazing the stuff you pick up when you just stand around and chat with guys. Greg Ostertag called me over a while ago. He says, you know Gary Bender. I says, very well. Good friend, fine broadcaster. He said, well, my wife is his son's ex-fiance.
Yeah, he stole it.
Yep. You got to follow this now.
There, yeah, I want to hear that one more time.
My wife is his son's ex-fiance. We indulge in a little, when it's a 17-point game, you start with this stuff.
I get that.
Greg Ostertag has really filled a role for them.
Yeah, he was the reason that they were able to not have to sign a Felton Spencer back. It was able to move him because of his play. He came on last year like gangbusters, had a great playoffs for them, and he plays that role like I talked about earlier, and that's why he's in the center spot now.
Maxwell, guarded by Hornacek, tries to take it. Off the glass short, Malone with the rebound. Here they come again. He looks for Stockton and finds him. Hornacek spots up and passes on the three as Cadillac Anderson is out there and not where he wants to be. Well, there's Stockton. Fakes it, drives it. The tip is good. And the lead is 20.
And the Spurs better be very careful because right now, not only are they beating them down court, they beat them on the boards also.
Midway through the second quarter, this game was tied 38-38. It's been all Utah since then.
The NBA on TNT is brought to you by GMC, putting you comfortably in command, and by Vila, change the game.
Here, I feel like traffic is miles away. With the most horsepower in its class and its accommodating size.
Unlike some others, I have virtually unlimited capacity.
Yukon can make you feel invincible. Yukon by GMC. It puts you comfortably in command.
This neighborhood. I'm from a small town in North Carolina, but some things here are just like home. Sure, every community has problems, but when everyone works together, it doesn't matter where you're from. So team up with your community, even if you are the new guy in town.
And second half, we talked so much about the Spurs and transition defense, and this is exactly what Greg Popovich wants from this team. Look here, Utah passes it up, and look at this. Four guys get back, and it stops them from getting a quick bucket, and that's what Greg Popovich needs from this team tonight. Transition defense.
Well, Utah, 9 transition baskets, San Antonio, none. And that is the difference in the game.
Yeah, and that's what he was concerned with. Unfortunately, it's happened.
Now, let's set those on the floor now. Herrera, Dominique Wilkins, Vinny Del Negro, Cadillac Anderson. And Wilkins calls for it. He's guarded double team now for one a few times. There's Stockton. They find the open man. Herrera cutting the basket.
And Knights cuts. Carl Herrera gets hit in the face once more. Oh,
ouch. Malone misfires. Herrera. They don't spot him.
I don't think he really wants the ball right now. He needs a 22nd.
Yep. Got popped right in the face.
Maybe.
Maybe it was south of the equator. Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah.
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 That was definitely down there in South America near Ecuador.
That wasn't the face.
Nope. Certainly wasn't.
But it hurt.
It hurts in Guatemala just like it hurts in Canada.
Oh, boy.
Oh, dear. The mask didn't save him then.
Great pass by Dominique out of the double team. And here's another guy, Dominique Wilkins, who has seen his share of double teams, so obviously you know he knows how to pass. And they're going right back with the same play.
Here comes the double from Karl Malone. Wilkins saves it. Hornacek comes back to help. Here's Malone again. Dominique Wilkins up and in.
Just split the double team, and he was patient. He was trying to read what Utah was going to do defensively. They trapped once, he reposted, and they didn't really want to trap twice.
16-point margin now, 8:50 to go, and a foul away from the ball.
San Antonio first foul number 7.
Yeah, look at, watch Dominique here. He's just waiting. He wants to see what's going on, and this is like a passive trap by Karl Malone, to say the least. That's why this guy is one of the greatest scorers in NBA history, because he knows how to read defenses.
Last foul was called on Karl Herrera, and Cadillac Anderson knocks it out of the hands of Greg Ostertag. There's the owner, Larry Miller, owner of the Utah Jazz.
And you can see in the second half, the Spurs have made a concerted effort to get back in transition. The problem is, in the first half, they've let themselves get down so far. It'll be interesting where they're going to get the points at to try to come back, and who they're going to find to stop Karl Malone.
Well, we've played 3.5 of the second half, and Malone has reached his game average of 26. Illegal defense, that's the first call tonight, so the warning.
Illegal defense warning
against Utah.
No protest from Jerry Sloan, so it probably was an illegal defense. He said he didn't mind getting an illegal defense call once or twice a game if he can get away with doing some things illegally that they don't see.
Jerry Sloan, number retired by the Chicago Bulls. the first number retired.
Yeah. There's a guy playing in Chicago with his number retired right now, too, and I think a lot of players in the league wish that had stayed up there in the Raptors.
San Antonio with the offensive board as we near the 8-minute mark of the third quarter. Avery Johnson finds Will Perdue, and then he finds Karl Malone. He gets called for the foul. Now let's check in with Dick Versace.
Well, guys, bad news for the San Antonio Spurs. Things are getting worse for them. Vernon Maxwell's got a flare-up, tendonitis in both knees, will not play the rest of the night.
Oh, man.
And then there were three.
Yeah.
They have three guys left on the bench right now. Oh, when it rains, it pours, Vernon.
Well, this is a flood of biblical proportion. Perdue misses both. Ostertag with the rebound. That's 9 rebounds for Ostertag. Our lead is 18 now for the Utah Jazz with 7:48 remaining in the third quarter. Underneath Malone for a rare time, not ready for it. And here comes Avery Johnson. Herrera harassed. Out of bounds. And this will be San Antonio ball. Phoenix playing in New York. And let's go to Ernie Johnson for bonus coverage of the Suns and the New York Knicks.
All right, thank you very much, Vern. 2-point game between the Suns and the Knicks. New York with the ball. We go to bonus coverage. Marv Albert and John Andres. Phoenix up by a deuce.
It was deflected out by the Suns. Houston trying so hard to get the ball to Ewing, released it, and it was nearly picked off. Knicks use their final timeout.
Well, Jeff Van Gundy, obviously not a big fan of bonus coverage, as they call timeout in the closing seconds. 94-92, the Suns. We'll keep you posted on that game. Let's go back to the Delta Center, guys.
To everybody.
Welcome back. An 18-point game here. Utah up by those 18 points. Dominique Wilkins gets two more.
Yep, he's making a case for himself.
Oh, is he ever? Right now.
He's making a case for himself not only with the Jazz, but a bunch of teams. Because one of the things Dominique can do is he can create points on his own. And when the playoffs basketball, it gets tight and slow, you need guys like that.
22 points for the 37-year-old. And Hornacek counters with two at the other end. Jeff Hornacek now with 8 points. And the lead is back to 18. Johnson, Perdue, Dominique Wilkins, Vinny Del Negro.
Oh, they're going back to Dominique. that's a given.
Now in the hands of Dominique, Brian Russell. Reach in foul on Brian Russell. And let's check in once again with Ernie Johnson for the finish at Madison Square Garden.
All right, Vern, let's try this thing again. They are in a timeout at Madison Square Garden. 94-92 is the count. There was a huge Phoenix lead, but an 18-2 run late in the third got the Knicks right back in this thing. Let's go to Marv and John.
30 or more. But the Knicks have to be ready for doubling and tripling of Ewing, which has not been happening tonight that much. So someone else has got to be ready, and you know Jeff Van Gundy has a contingency plan.
The Phoenix Suns team that has won only 5 of 28 games on the road. Knicks do not have any timeouts left. Down to 10 seconds. Ewing. Childs passed on the three. 5 seconds. Houston for three. Starks, he'll have to fire it. He does. Got it off the zone. He hit it. It's over. The Knicks have won in dramatic fashion. And the Suns, with an argument, they felt that it should not have counted. Several of the players felt the shot came after time had run out. But it counts. Jack Neese with the immediate indication. John Starks with a three-pointer to win it for the Knicks at the buzzer. The Knicks 95 and the Suns 94.
How about the poise of Starks to make sure his feet were ready. I think that's incredible what he did, because he knew he had no time, but he held out to get his body in the position that he wanted to get it in. And once again, the Knicks spot the opponent the big lead. They were down by as many as 16, and they come from behind to pull it out. Here's a look at the play now. The rush shot doesn't go. Starks gets the ball. He knows he's just about out of time. And on the release, it's gone before the zeros are across the board. It certainly was close, and if you are the Suns, you argue.
I thought it was a good call. Very, very close.
Oh, no question.
Did get it off. Tough call. Jack Nease.
It wasn't out of his hands, but a half a second or less. And then the shot, the time clock ran out. Another look at it, all angles here. The Knicks get the good bounce. You know what that good bounce reminds me of? The game in Charlotte. When that ball went into Glenn Rice's hands off a rebound. And the Knicks were the victims of a good bounce. Here, they got the good bounce, and they got the Glenn Rice-type response from John Starks.
Well, Jeff Van Gundy was saying prior to the game, so important to win the final game of the homestand before going on the long road trip. That is awfully close, but it looked like he just did get it off by a split second.
They got the lucky bounce and the great finish from John Starks, who is a dramatic shooter. Boy, he's shown.
Just the way they drew it up. The Knicks win it at the buzz. Bonus coverage here on TNT. 95-94. Ewing with 31, but John Starks the hero. The Knicks make it six straight wins. They are unbeaten since the All-Star break, keeping the heat on Miami in the Atlantic. Now we go back to Utah.
Right, EJ, keeping the heat on Miami.
They really are. I tell you what, everybody in New York is watching. They can't stand right now in New York that Pat Riley's Miami Heat is in front of them.
In the meantime, we've got a close one here as Dominique Wilkins and Jeff Hornacek have caught fire for the San Antonio Spurs. They've cut a 20-point margin to 11 with 3:08 to go, third quarter. The dish underneath, Malone, and the basket counts. Oh, what a pass.
This team passes the ball so well. If you try to trap, they make an adjustment. If you try to front, they make an adjustment. That time, that was just a great cut. Benny Del Negro lost eye contact with Hornacek, and it killed him.
Jeff Hornacek has hit his last five shots from the free field. Had a chance for a three-point play now. Dominique Wilkins is going to get a rest, and he heads to the bench with 24 points tonight. Del Negro and Corey Alexander, Cadillac Anderson, Avery Johnson, and Will Perdue for San Antonio.
And Del Negro and Dominique Wilkins are the two guys offensively who have kept the Spurs in this game.
A 13-point margin, 3 to go, third quarter. Back to Avery Johnson. In the corner to Del Negro. Finds Alexander. Del Negro works hard for it and gets it.
I tell you what, that was great offense, ball moving by the Spurs, but it was even better defense. Everywhere they passed it, there was a Jazz player. Benny Del Negro just makes a tough shot.
At the other end, however, here's Brian Russell. Back to a 13-point margin and a chance to go to 14.
We have a timeout now taken by the Jazz.
Benny Del Negro, as San Antonio has hit its last seven shots to keep it a game.
Call your cable operator today and ask about CNN SI, the sports news network.
Perhaps even more impressive than pure, unbridled power is the ability to harness it. Sierra by GMC, putting you comfortably in command.
He wants a new Mazda. She wants a used Mazda. So how did they find happiness? They went to Cable Dahmer Mazda in Independence, because Cable Dahmer Mazda emphasizes both new and used. A big selection of new Mazda trucks, minivans, and the Miata, and a big selection of high-quality late-model used cars, foreign and domestic, with nice people to help you. So if you're looking for new, but you'd rather buy used, or vice versa, see both new and used at Cable Dahmer Mazda on the Miracle Mile, Nolan Road, Independence.
Hungry? Follow me. At the station, we've got 12 great restaurants to choose from, more than anyone else. Real Italian food. Mwah. Delicious Mexican. The freshest seafood this side of Louisiana. And the all-you-can-eat feast around the world. 5 restaurants in one. Great food and great fun. The station always gives you more. Let's go!
One of the few bright spots for San Antonio this season, the resurgence of Dominique Wilkins. Remember, 12 years in Atlanta, he was called the human highlight film. He won 2 slam dunk championships. After a brief stop in Boston, he was away from the NBA for a year. A year he says forget when he spent that year in Greece. But now back in San Antonio and a serious candidate for comeback player of the year. Here's the irony in what's going on here tonight. He was originally a draft choice of the Utah Jazz back in 1982, traded for $1 million and a couple of players, and wouldn't it be ironic if he wound up back here?
It really would be, and if this was a tryout, Dominique has made the squad. I tell you that, he's having one great performance. He has really struggled since the All-Star break, and another, you know, he always struggles early in the season, and his MO has been he struggles at the All-Star break because he's one of those guys that over break, he takes a break. He doesn't do a whole bunch. And at this age, he's finding out that now he needs to work out over break, and he's starting to get back into tune, and you can see it tonight.
Far be it from us to indulge in rumor and speculation.
Oh, boy, I tell you.
I mean, we would never stoop so low. But Larry Miller, I think, is liking what he's seeing.
Yeah,
and, of course, we've had hints all day. You heard Dick Versace at the beginning of the broadcast say there is some thought given to the fact that Dominique might be wearing purple before the trade deadline is over.
I tell you what, right now, Vinny Del Negro is trying out for the Jazz also. He's on fire.
The lead is 11. Del Negro with 19 points. He's hit his last 5 shots. Howard Eisley has replaced Stockton. Here's Eisley off the dribble. Kicks it out from Brian Russell.
It's interesting. Every time the Spurs score a 2, it seems like the Jazz comes back with a 3, either a 3-point shot or a 3-point play.
And they are not a team that uses that 3-point shot much.
They don't need it, Vern. They get layups.
That helps when you're shooting. That helps you shoot 49%.
Yeah.
3-point field goals in the quarter. San Antonio 2 of 8. Del Negro and Utah 1 of 6.
Yeah, but Utah has about 4 other 3-point shots where
right.
They scored the 2 and got fouled and then made a free throw.
Corey Alexander gets the first. Now time to look at tonight's GMC scoreboard. And don't forget to catch Nick Charles and Steve Bartlestein at 11 o'clock on the simulcast of CNNSI. 24-hour sports news network, CNN, and Sports Illustrated. 90 seconds to go. Brian Russell underneath, knocked out of bounds. San Antonio ball.
San Antonio is scratching their way back in the game. And one of the things we've missed in the second half, I don't know when the last time I saw a transition score for Utah. They have made the adjustment, San Antonio, and now they're back in the game.
Del Negro kicks it left. 3-pointer. Corey Alexander from Vinny Del Negro, and it's a single-digit game again.
And you can see the pep back in the Spurs. About 5 or 6 minutes ago, when they were down 20 or 18, we thought that they were starting to sag down. Now they're back. They feel they have a shot in this game.
Here come the Spurs running again. Right side, Alexander kicks it back. Nope, hangs on to it, though. Little half.
That was one of the few chances they had to score in transition.
Del Negro, Hornacek guards him. Fall away from Del Negro, no. And into the hands of Howard Eisley. 81-72 with 35 seconds to go in the quarter.
Back to Hornacek, goes by Del Negro, puts it up and in.
Oh, what a tough shot.
Whoa.
Yeah, and I think he started the match, Vinny Del Negro, and who's the hottest right now?
5 second difference, shot clock and game clock. And 10 on the shot clock now for San Antonio. Antoine Carr is on the floor. They kick it, knocked out of bounds by Hornacek. And 5 seconds remaining in the shot clock.
You got it?
San Antonio out of bounds, 5 seconds.
And Vinny Del Negro will inbound it.
This is a big 10.9 seconds for the Spurs. They need a bucket, but more importantly, if they don't get a bucket, they can't allow 8 points for Utah.
Del Negro.
Whoa! My goodness. I tell you what, him and Jeff Hornacek right now, they're playing a game of force.
Isley at the other end. Air ball. And the quarter will end on Hornacek's jumper. 13 points for Vinny Del Negro in the quarter. And the San Antonio Spurs down by 20 early in this half. Scratch and claw back with shots like that. They're down by 9 with 12 minutes remaining. Something brewing here in Salt Lake.
That answers that question.
With Sierra's strength and exceptional power, life's daily obstacles are easily handled. But with Sierra's third door, you'll have one less hurdle to overcome. Sierra by GMC. Putting you comfortably in command.
People call you guys bunny spotters, is that right?
Bunny spotters. I think that it trivializes what we do. It's much larger than that.
I mean, once you've seen it, you can never go back. There's no other pink like that.
He's been through here.
Bump, bump.
Bump, bump.
Bump, bump.
I've seen it 16 times. To watch somebody find it, see it for the first time.
Whoa. I feel very fortunate to be here. Because, you know, when we're all gone, it's still going to be out there.
Team is important, part of a team.
Like a family.
Because, hey, you can't win unless you're part of a team.
There you go, right there. Good.
When I go out on the court, I give everything I have and I leave it out there.
This is great. I mean, you have fun with your teammates. You hang out with your teammates. Yeah, we fuss and fight, but, hey, we fight for each other on and off the court. We're family, yeah. But we're going to take care of business. It's not about one. It's about together. That's what team is all about. I want it to be real, you know what I'm saying?
Welcome back to Salt Lake City as we get set for the start of the final quarter. Vern Lundquist, Doc Rivers, and Dick Versace. As night has fallen in this beautiful city. And in the third quarter, Vinny Del Negro and Dominique Wilkins sparked the San Antonio comeback. Dominique now with 24 points and 30 minutes of play. They kept going back to him, and then Del Negro got hot. 9 of 12 from the field for Vinny Del Negro in the ball game. He scored 21 points in 20 minutes. He had 13, including this acrobatic jumper at the end of the quarter. And the San Antonio Spurs find themselves down by 9. Greg Popovich saying, Doc, this morning with us, the one thing he cannot fault these guys on is hustle and attitude.
Yeah, you have to be really impressed with the job Greg Popovich is doing in this team, because they have every reason to quit. There's so many injuries on this team. They have every reason to quit. They're down 20 points in this game. They've cut it down to a 9-point game. They're on the road, and they've done it because they've done two things. One, they found two guys who can score, and two, they've eliminated transition offense. Their transition defense has turned it up.
But just like that, Shannon Anderson with an acrobatic basket under the hoop. Avery Johnson, Purdue, Del Negro, Cadillac Anderson, and Corey Alexander. Here's Del Negro for three.
He's still feeling it. He's still feeling it. Somebody better find him.
Well, he looks over at Ron Doolin and Kobe Dietrich, the Spurs broadcasters. He spent much of the second quarter looking over at you.
Yeah. In dismay. Now he's on fire. That's just a mismatch right there, folks. Shannon Anderson, A.J. Johnson, Avery Johnson, he's just too small. He's just too small to guard a guy like that. That's what Shannon Anderson has brought to this team, a big guard who can score, but even more importantly, a big guard who can play defense on big guards around the league.
John Stockton, guarded by Avery Johnson. 85-77. Malone. To Antoine Carr, Morris, Stockton with a jumper.
Ball movement, spacing. That was the clinic.
Pretty. And a 10-point game once again. Second meeting of the season between these two. Here's Dominique Wilkins. Won't fall. Antoine Carr gets it. Chris Morris at the other end of the court, but they go with the half-court set. Dominique Wilkins guards Morris. Here's Malone. Cadillac Anderson on him. Stockton Pretty.
Watching this team play offense is a treat.
It's a pretty good unit.
And this is the old Statue of Liberty play. And they run it to with perfection.
Gravity by Foot Locker.
Of all the laws of nature, you are my least favorite.
It's not your fault you exist, but gravity.
You are no friend of mine.
You do not belong in my house.
My house.
Though you show up every morning.
I defy you, gravity. You are not my obstacle.
That grin you see. That's me knowing I will beat you.
If only for an instant.
Even if it's just for an instant.
Foot Locker, where it all begins and gravity ends.
How about something hot? Just look for the dot. Choose from three delicious crusts. There's classic hand-tossed, crunchy thin crust, thick ultimate deep dish.
Wow.
Whatever you wish. So tell us how and pick one now. Call now and you can enjoy a delicious Domino's pizza during the game. And why not add on some of Domino's spicy buffalo wings or steaming hot breadsticks?
And Magic, 8 Eastern, Wednesday night on the Superstation.
And now it's time to take a look at tonight's Dutch boy in the paint. Fast break points, Utah 14-0, but all 14 came in the first half. And at the line, the Jazz hit their first 20, only two of their last five. San Antonio has kept pace. Let's check in with Dick Versace.
Well, guys, Greg Popovich is very, very upset about the energy level defensively and the breakdowns that have occurred in the last few trips. In particular, he's upset about the post defense. He's warning his guys to meet the postman early and not let him go down and set up.
Yeah, you can see early in the game, he was more worried about transition D, and now Utah has found another way of scoring. They go to the post, and that's why this team is so good. They find different ways of scoring. They can kill you in a lot of different areas.
Dominique Wilkins has it taken away by Chris Morris, and then the loose ball is off Carl Malone. And Jerry Sloan and Malone both disagree with that call from Nolan Fine.
Yeah, and I'm surprised Carl Malone doesn't pick up a technical foul. He did every hand gesture possible except for some of the bad ones.
Saved one.
Yes.
He kept a clenched fist. Avery Johnson penetrates, dishes to Perdue, travels. Now it's Will Perdue's time to argue.
Yeah, but I tell you what, he better not do the same thing Karl Malone. He will get attacked.
11 turnovers. Only 9 for Utah, and they had 7 in the first quarter.
San Antonio first foul break.
And Malone is fouled by Cadillac Anderson. Well, the week continues. On Turner tomorrow night, Portland goes in to take on the Orlando Magic and interim coach Richie Adubato. That'll be an interesting confrontation. And then Friday night, Chicago at Washington, and next Tuesday night, the Lakers at the Houston Rockets.
It really is amazing. It seems like it never fails. When a coach is fired, his team, the next game, is on a national televised basketball game.
Chuck Daly and Bob Neal will be in Orlando for that game tomorrow night. Interesting scenario in the firing of Brian Hill, with John Gabriel talking today about a meeting led by Penny Hardaway and the players, after which they came and said, we want to change.
And I have to take John Gabriel out to task on that. I don't think you do that. I think you are the guy who made the call. You fired him. You made the decision, and you need to take the heat, not Penny Hardaway. And though Penny Hardaway might not have done it, it looks like he did, and that's a bad sign.
Shannon Anderson coast to coast, and the lead is back to 15. A 7-0 Utah run. Well, Doc, you were comparing it with the way Bob Hill was dismissed in San Antonio and how that was handled.
Well, the difference is Greg Popovich made the call. He took all the heat. He's still getting heat in San Antonio. He gave no reasons for it. He just said it was my decision. And I think that's what you have to do at times.
Take a look at this Utah defense again.
And it's a help defense. You watch Utah. John Stockton is beat. Antoine Carr helps out, and when you're beat and you help out, you cause a turnover, and then you have your transition going. That's what Utah does very well, and they've done it all night.
Antoine Carr with the block, 1 of 8. Utah has put back at San Antonio tonight. Here's Del Negro at the free throw line. And I go back to your thoughts at the beginning of the night. The San Antonio team, 36-13 at the same point a year ago. They've won 12 this year. And guys like Vinny Del Negro and Avery Johnson, and how they're suffering through this.
Yeah, Will Perdue, who's been on championship teams in Chicago. You know, this is a team with a lot of pride, and they understand that if they had all their horses, they might be one of those teams we were talking about that had a chance to win the West. And now they're playing every game to keep games close and have moral victories. That's a tough transition for this team.
Well, and with the prospect of David Robinson coming back, that was a turnover against Utah. Foul, offensive foul on John Stockton, was first. You know, realistically, you're not looking at much of a chance of making the playoffs, so you're thinking lottery.
Yeah, you have to
get
the
lottery. You can't tell your team that. Or can you? Avery Johnson.
Oh. Number 4.
Nolan Fine made that call.
Well, I tell you what, Vernon. We talked about this before the game. I asked Jerry Sloan. I was talking to John Stockton over the All-Star break, and I said, John, now that I'm gone,